Hello and I welcome you to a tutorial session where today we'll be focusing on solving a few problems related to the meters. Let me start with the first problem. A permanent magnet moving coil ammeter has the following specification. Here, given the specification, we are supposed to determine the number of turns required to produce a deflection of 90 degree when a current flows through the coil. So whenever you start with a problem, first jot down the given data as you read the problem. Let me again read the problem in detail. So the specification starts with the coil dimension, which is 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. If you could see here, all the other parameters are scale based on meter, and hence we are supposed to convert this coil dimension also to meter, and in turn we'll be having the area, which is 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 the whole square, which is 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. And then the spring constant for this moving coil ammeter is given. At times, we may not be provided with the spring constant deliberately. Instead, the coil's material could be specified, like moving coil made of copper or moving coil made of aluminium. These are the two different materials using which they would be manufacturing moving coil. And hence, it is better for us to remember the spring constant of aluminium and copper. But here it is given in the problem, so we could use this directly. And the flux density is also given, which is 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 Weber per meter square. And now, let me read the problem, the next line. With a different flow, let me start from here. When a current of 2 milliampere flows through the coil, the current flowing through the permanent magnet moving coil ammeter, which is the moving coil is given, which is I is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. And this current is going to produce a deflection of 90 degree. So theta is equal to 90 degree, whereas spring constant is Newton meter per radian. So we are supposed to convert this degree to radian. So converting it to radian, it is pi by 2 radian. Now we are going to determine the number of turns, which is capital A. So looking at all these parameters, we could say we are going to determine N, and we will be having some formula related to N, B, A, I, and most of you would have figured out the formula. If you have not figured out the formula, see, for every meter we have to start from the steady state condition, or we call it as the equilibrium condition. At equilibrium, the deflecting tar will be equal to the controlling tar. Here, as you have a moving coil, the deflecting tar is going to be NBAI, which we have already studied. And the control is through spring, and hence the controlling tar is going to be K theta. So from this, on cross multiplying, you could find the value of N. So finally, take down a paper and your calculator and substitute and calculate the values of N, because all other parameters are known already. So direct substitution is going to give you the value of N. So on substitution, N is going to be equal to 785. That is 785 turns in the moving coil will be producing a deflection of 90 degree when 2 milliampere current flows through the coil. Over to the next problem. So here We have a moving coil instrument which gives a full scale deflection of 20 milliampere. Full scale deflection of 20 milliampere, and when I make this current of 20 milliampere flow through the meter, it is going to have a potential difference of 400 millivolt. If you could see here, this instrument is designed for a full scale deflection of 200 ampere. So now let me start the problem by breaking it into two parts. So first, for the case 1, let me say here the full scale deflection is arrived when I flow a current of 20 milliampere. So this is the current which is going to flow through the meter. So I give the index Im. So Im is equal to 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. And when I make this current flow through the meter, a potential difference across the meter is going to be voltage across the meter. Please never don't mistake this as the maximum current or the maximum voltage. It is the current through the meter's coil and it is the potential difference across the meter. So potential difference across the meter Vm is going to be equal to 400 millivolt, which is 400 into 10 to the power minus 3 ohm. So given the voltage across the meter and current across the meter, it is easier for us to find the resistance across the meter. So resistance of the moving coil, which is the resistance of the meter, by Ohm's law is Vm by Im, which is equal to 400 divided by 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 will get cancelled, so I have not mentioned it here. And that is equal to 20 ohm. Here in this case, the coil might possess inductance in practical scenario, but here we are going to neglect the presence of the inductance in the coil, and we are going to say the coil is purely resistive or predominantly resistive, and it is going to produce a full scale deflection when I flow a current 200 ampere. Now this 200 ampere cannot flow through the meter because the meter is designed for a current of 20 milliampere. So only a small fraction of current, 20 milliampere out of this 200 ampere, could flow through the instrument. So in order to divert the rest of the current, majority of the current, we need a shunt resistance. So now we are going to determine the value of shunt resistance. And if you could remember this formula, here it goes as I is equal to Im 1 plus Rm, where Rm is the resistance of the meter divided by the resistance of the shunt path. So here again, on direct substitution, will be having the value of shunt resistance. Now to the second part. So here we are going to design a meter to show a full scale deflection of 1000 volt. So 1000 volt, here we are going to design a voltmeter, and this voltmeter will always carry a fraction of current, and hence the current, when you have a path with more resistance, automatically the current through the path is also going to decrease. So we are going to design a path with larger resistance, and that path is assigned for the meter. So to the second case, we have a voltage of 1000 volt which is to be measured. So accordingly, I am supposed to design the meter. So in that case, I will be using a series resistance, and on substituting, we have RSE is equal to 49.98 kilo ohm. So here, kindly understand the concept behind the construction of an ammeter and voltmeter. For designing an ammeter, we'll be using a resistance, a lower value of resistance along the shunt path, whereas to design a voltmeter, a very high value of resistance is connected in series with the moving coil. So that is how we convert the same moving coil instrument as an ammeter and a voltmeter.